Hi everyone, and welcome to another instructional video for the Skookum Robotics SK720. Now that we've completed all of the setup wizards, we're going to go over a short final checkout of the SK720 and your heli setup. First on our list is checking the swash movement in relation to control inputs. Starting with the collective stick, move the stick towards you. The swash plate should move downwards. Move the stick up, and the swash moves up as well. If the heli is in flight mode, the swash also tilts forward slightly to compensate for tail drag during climbouts. Now with the cyclic stick, move the stick towards you and the swash plate should tilt towards the heli's tail. Pushing the stick away from you, the swash should tilt towards the heli's nose. Left movement on the stick should tilt the swash left, and right on the stick should tilt the swash right. Looking at the tail now, we're going to check for proper blade direction. Move your rudder control to command nose left. If your blades don't move with the tips facing towards the tail, you need to reverse your tail servo. Check in the other direction, when you move your control stick to command the heli to go nose right, your blades should move with the tips facing away from the heli's tail. Finally, we're going to check the swash and tail movement in relation to moving the heli itself. Disconnect your motor and power up the SK720 and servos. Next, pick up the heli and tilt it nose down. The swash plate will move against the direction of the heli's movement as the SK720 attempts to correct the movement. We'll repeat this check, tilting the heli nose up, then rolling it left and right. The swash plate should move against the heli's movement in all directions. If you have self-level turned off, the swash plate won't hold its movement. It'll return level in relation to the heli's orientation. If you have self-level on, the swash plate will hold its attempts to correct the heli's movement until the heli is absolutely level. The tail will also attempt to correct any unwanted movement. As I yaw the heli back and forth, you can see the tail pitch adjust accordingly. The tail will also compensate for unwanted movement when increasing the throttle. The small blip you see is the tail compensating for the increase in the motor's torque. I'll now show you a short field demo. Before flying our heli, we check our collective function, aileron and elevator, and the tail. Picking the heli up and tilting it to the side, we make sure that the swash plate fights the tilt, then slowly returns to level. We then repeat this check, tilting the heli forwards and backwards. Finally, we turn on the self-level bank to make sure that the swash plate stays level with self-level turned on. For our first flight with the SK720, we simply hover our heli to make sure our vibration levels are low enough for the self-level to function properly. If the SK720's LED flashes red and green after you land, your vibrations are too high. However, if you're not using self-level, you don't need to worry about vibrations. Looking at the flybarless flight characteristics of the SK720, the heli will take off and hover without cyclic control inputs or self-level. Once we're in the air, the heli moves sideways and holds the motion with a short control input in each direction. It only changes direction when we give it the control to move to the other side. The same principle applies to forward flight. The heli holds its forward motion with only a single cyclic input. In our next video, we'll cover the setup and flight characteristics of the self-level system. Again, thanks for flying Skookum Robotics and happy flying!